What's going on, bro?
What's going on? The intro is going to be awkward.
Mad awkward.
What's going on?
Nah, man. I'm right, man. What are you saying?
I'm good, man.
Yeah?
I'm good, yeah.
Yeah? First things first, before we get into anything, I'm a person who likes to pre a lot of tweets and shit like that, yeah?
Yeah.
Now, obviously, you're from South, like myself.
Yeah.
Yeah? But you support Liverpool, though.
Oh, come on.
Why? Why?
Do you know what? Yeah, I get ripped about this a lot. But my mum is originally from Liverpool, isn't it? So like, I've got like a lot of older brothers and sisters as well. So my older brother lives in Liverpool as well. So growing up, I've just been drummed in my head. I'm a Liverpool fan. Like my mum's a football hooligan. So like, she used to have like season tickets for Liverpool. Like my older brother is named after a Liverpool player back in the day. Then
friggin' hell,
yeah,
what player?
It's crazy, Emlyn Hughes. So my older brother's called M. Emmy,
they get me. Oh, okay.
Because of, do you get me? My mum was a football hooligan, so I didn't really have no choice, man.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're doing all right now.
Yeah, where do you think you're going to finish, though? That's the real question.
Do you know what? Yeah, I had the heartbreak a few years ago, didn't I? When Stevie dropped, do you get me?
When he slipped up.
Yeah, man. I thought we had it that year. So, I don't know, man. Hopefully we do well this year. We ain't got no European football, so we got an advantage, so hopefully we take it this year.
That's right, man. I feel kind of bad because obviously I'm from South as well, but I support Man United.
But you're the worst. That just means you're a glory hammer.
See, my reason ain't quite as good. You got a proper reason behind yours.
What's your reason?
Mine's just like, obviously I'm from Tanzania, yeah.
Yeah.
So like, the only teams you really see in Tanzania when I was young was like Man United, Barcelona.
Yeah.
And like, my dad used to support a team in Tanzania called Simba, and they wear red tops.
Oh, okay.
So I thought, Man United's going to be my
wear
team.
Liverpool wear red tops as well, you know?
But, nah, but they never spoke about Liverpool like that.
Aye.
And I was on players like Beckham and that from young.
Oh, yeah.
So I thought, when I get to London, that's going to be my team, so I stuck with it.
I hear you. Have you been a Man United fan like your whole life?
Like, just before I came to London, I remember like my dad buying me like a Eric Cantona top and like Man United pencil cases and school. So you kind of just get into it. And
of course.
By the time you grow up to realise what you're doing, it's too late. You've had too many arguments to change your team.
Yeah, of course.
So you have to kind of just stick on it.
Yeah, I know them ones. So what, you was born out there? Okay,
yeah,
so
yeah,
when
yeah.
did you come in?
So I came when I was 8 years old.
Okay.
So I was born there. Imagine that. It's mad hot out there.
I can imagine, yeah.
And then getting here, I got here in December.
Okay.
And it was
winter,
freezing.
I know that's something you would never forget.
Bro, never that was the first time I saw snow. First time.
That's crazy.
It was nuts for me.
Crazy.
And I didn't even know how to speak English.
Yeah.
Like, I just spoke Swahili.
Okay.
So I had to go through the process of like learning a new language like completely.
Yeah. You gotta teach me some of that.
Yes, I'll teach you.
Yeah,
we'll go out there.
Yeah.
I'll teach you how to say a couple things to the girls out there.
Say no more. Make sure it's the right things. Make sure it's the right things.
Nah, trust me. When they see like a lighty out there,
they'll
go mad still.
Yeah.
They'll go mad.
Hopefully.
Like, I've been like a fan of your music for a long time.
Oh, thank you.
Like, even from the early times when you was just doing like freestyles.
Yeah.
And like, it's been sick to watch you like progress and grow like as an artist. And you're definitely like a punchline sort of guy, do you get what I mean?
Yeah,
so I wanna know what's like your writing process behind the punchlines? Do you kinda have them in your head already and then kinda bring it all together, or?
Yeah, it's weird, like I see a lot of things, like for example, like there's a sofa in front of us now. Sometimes I'll just be like, always in like a creative zone, do you know what I mean? So like, I'll see the sofa and I'll think, I could use a sick way to like put sofa and so far
together.
Like, it just comes like that, and then I'll put it down in my archives and it might be there for 6 months, but when the right song comes along, I think, I can slip it in there. Or
yeah.
Like, that's how like a lot of like my punches come up.
Yeah.
And I like, I find it hard now. Before, I used to just be able to go studio and just write everything down. And like, or I'd write it in my phone, in my BlackBerry, but now I find it hard to just go studio and just write. Like, I have to sit there and zone. And just zone and then just create together.
Yeah.
And then I go in my archives and then I just work from like my archives like that. So that I don't necessarily sick. Just write something straight. Do you get what I mean now?
Yeah. I like it, man. There's nothing better than like when punchlines are used like in the right way.
Yeah.
It just sounds sick.
Do you know what my main thing with punchlines as well? Because when I first started punchlining, I would say something like, "You man ain't wavy, seaside." You know, like the basic ones.
I remember the early ones.
The early ones. But as it goes on now, I try to make like my punches make total sense. That even if it wasn't a punch, it would make sense. So I would just say it in a lyric. Like, I remember I said a bar on Link Up TV. Like, it's probably one of my favourite punchlines ever. On my behind bars, I said, "Death's the only thing you don't hear coming."
Yeah.
But it's a punch. But it's like, it still makes perfect sense.
Exactly.
Do you know what I mean? Like, yeah, I love the punching.
That's actually a sick class, though. Yeah, that's kind of sick. You know, when you were talking, I was thinking about like, what?
What's he talking about?
Yeah. I was like, there's no punch in that.
Oh, yeah, no. But it's like, it's weird. I had that one in my archives for ages. But, yeah. This year, man, we done, like, I done loads of festivals. I see you done Glasgow as well.
How was that? Mad. Yeah. Like, I think the whole festival thing is sick, yeah?
Yeah.
Because it's like, people are not there necessarily to see you.
Yeah.
But it's up to you to kind of win them over.
Of course,
Do you get what I mean? So that's the beauty part of it, of like, okay, I'm going to play some new songs that people ain't heard before. They might hear a couple.
Yeah.
But you have to sort of impress them, and it helps you grow as a performer the more you do it.
Of course.
So like for me, festivals, they've been sick, especially like even European ones as well.
I've never done no European festivals.
Yeah,
but I see you shutting down. I was on Twitter, man. And I think you was doing Swear Down, and I saw a video of you doing Swear Down.
Yeah,
I was like, where was this? Like, this was nuts. Like,
nuts.
Yeah, where was it?
In Germany, I think.
Sick.
There's a festival out there called Sound of the Forest.
Okay,
where it's like in the middle of a forest, like it's surrounded by a forest,
Oh, I swear to God.
And there's a stage in the middle, and people just go there. It's
that
mad.
That must be nuts.
Mad.
That must be nuts, man. When I was like doing festivals with Naughty, and we was doing European festivals back then. But this is like when I wasn't doing it as myself. Like, I was just coming out doing some tunes with Naughty and stuff. But they like, Europe is crazy, and they got like a big thing for like hard stuff as well.
Yeah.
I like it.
Trust me, man. What's been like your favorite festival this year?
I have a Reading. Or Wireless, I reckon.
I've never done Wireless, you know?
You've never done Wireless? Never. I've done it like, I've been blessed to be able to do it like every year.
That
like,
is sick.
This is the first year I've actually been booked. Last year I was booked for it on the Disturbing London had a stage.
Yeah.
And they brought like me, Sneakbow, Bugsy Malone, like a few sick acts. But this year's the first year I had like my own slot.
Yeah.
And it was proper sick, man. Like, it was proper sick. Every other year I've come out for like Krypton Conan or whatever. I come out for them again this year on main stage.
Yeah.
It was sick. But Wireless is sick. Definitely a festival you need to do.
Yeah.
Did you do Reading and Leeds and shit?
Nah. But I saw the little clips from that as well.
Reading
off
and Leeds, proper, like, they're one. That's probably one of my favorite festivals.
Yeah,
100%.
That is sick. Never done that either. 100%. Never done that either, man. It's sick. You know what? It's actually good to see like the scene moving forward and everyone's getting booked at festivals.
100%.
Like, I think everyone's talking about the UK scene about how sick it is at the moment.
Yeah,
like. And one thing that's helping us is by people collaborating and doing all these things.
Yeah.
Like, if you had to pick one artist from the UK that you haven't worked with before, to be like, yeah, I want to make a song with this guy, who would you say?
I have a few, you know. I done a track the other day with a new up-and-coming like writer and stuff. He's proper sick, but the track, like, I hear Ed on it.
Oh, yeah?
And it's like, I proper hit Ed Sheeran on it.
Yeah.
And I'm a massive fan of Ed.
He's sick.
And he's someone I really, really want to work with.
Mm.
He gives like a different feel, man.
Trust me, and he understands. He understands arting.
Trust me.
Do you know what I mean? Sometimes you work with people.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And they don't really get it, but
they don't get it, of course.
Mm.
But him, and if it was a rapper, it'd probably be Giggs. Like, I've never worked with Giggs.
But like, swear down.
Never worked with him, man. But obviously, growing up, like we was talking about this earlier. Like Giggs has been the guy growing up. Like if you're a rapper and you wasn't listening to Giggs growing up, I don't know. But that would be a moment for me if I ever get to work with Giggs, man.
He's like, yeah.
Legends in this thing.
He's like just killing right everything. Now. Like,
and do you know what? Like, I've only like properly got to meet him in the last year or so.
Yeah.
Like, properly, I had to sit down and talk to him. But he's the coolest guy ever.
Yeah.
Like, he's so cool, man. Like, and yeah, man, I've got so much love for that guy.
Yeah, man.
What's it called?
I can tell he's like that, man.
Yeah, he's cool. What was I gonna say? One of my favorite tunes. Yay. With Nans. Not even one of my favourite tunes with you, like, favourite tunes, period.
Sick.
How did that come about?
Just speaking on, like, he was one of my favourite rappers in the UK. Like, obviously, growing up, I used to listen to, like, Blade Brown, Giggs, Nines, Joe Black, just bare UK rap. I was on it.
Yeah.
So I thought, whenever I get the opportunity to do something, I want to work with all of them.
Yeah,
and yeah, it just came up, like Show and Prove, who was the producer.
Yeah,
he knows a couple of people that Nines knows.
Okay.
And we just thought, oh, you know what, let's do a hook. I done a hook and sent it to them. And yeah, Nines thought it was sick, so he wanted to lace it.
Even a video, like.
Yeah.
Nines is the guy for videos as well. Like,
sick.
His videos are always top notch, man. But,
so sick.
Nah, that's a big tune, man.
Thanks, man. Tune, yeah, man. Bare people like that tune.
Do you know what I think is so sick about it? That you can do that, and then you can still go and do the massive records, like Swear Down, like the commercial stuff. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, I feel like, and there's the balance. Sometimes it's like, oh, he's doing the underground stuff, he's forcing it. But it's not like that with you. You can tell that. Like, you come from that. You can tell that that's what you grew up on, do you get me?
Exactly. And then,
but you can tell that like, you're a proper musician
when
you go and do something like Swear Down. Do you get me? Like,
it's true, man.
I love that, man.
It's true. Like, obviously, I just get in different spaces. If I'm with my band and we're jamming something, I get influenced by a lot of jazz music, like, from Tanzania.
Yeah.
So I'll do that. But at the same time, me and all my friends, all we listen to is, like, UK rap. I wasn't even the sort of person that just used to listen to American raps. I used to listen like
just
to UK rap, people. And growing up, it was even more like just like the rappers in my area.
Do
you know what I mean?
Where are you from?
New Cross.
New Cross.
Yeah.
Southside.
Exactly. So I just used to listen to like people around Lewisham and Peckham. That's it. Or Brixton, obviously, like Roadside G's, like old school, like
legends in this thing.
As you get what I mean? Yeah. Like, if I told someone I used to listen to Roadside G's, they'd think, right, I could never guess that.
Yeah, but of course.
That's the sort of music that I liked.
I love that.
And that's the stuff that influences me to write lyrics and speak about the area that I'm from. And hopefully people kind of relate to it.
Yeah, do you know what I think? That gives you more of a story, man.
Yeah.
Like, I feel that gives you more of a story. Like, it makes you be able to make an album. Like, and the album not just be about one thing, do you know what I mean? And When you like gain fans from doing this, and then they be able to buy your album and see, oh wow, he's come from this.
Exactly.
I think that's sick, man.
It's true, man. And you're just being true to yourself more than anything. Yeah. Like, that's why, obviously, me and you got a song, Swear Down, and I feel like that bridges a gap a little bit in terms of like I can play that to my mum and she'll like it,
of course,
but I can play it to some of my friends and my friends will say, yeah, this was wavy,
of course.
Do you get what I mean?
Do you know, it's so weird you say that because my mum hit me and she's like, oh, I love your new track, son. But I know she hears better than new tunes.
Yeah.
But she don't usually hit me and say that. She's like, I love the new tracks. I was like, oh, which one are you talking about? So the one with Tix the Awful. I was like, oh, you like that one, yeah?
Sick.
So that just shows, bruv, like, My mom don't really like the hard stuff. She don't like the grimes of that.
Nah, sick. That's sick. That's sick. Especially, you see on the song, you've got a lyric like, I met her on a Monday, took her for a drink on a Tuesday. By Wednesday, she was in my DM. Obviously, it's not that easy for all of us. You know what I'm saying? Like, what, 2 days, 2 days, that's what you're on.
Listen, obviously, I'm just trying to be like Craig, you get me? That sort of thing. I might bring back the channel.
But Wednesday, I saw it took Craig a little bit longer.
I don't even remember what.
Quick. He's,
bro. Wait, I'm trying to figure what day Craig had it.
Man, Monday, took a drink on a Tuesday. We'll make it up.
We got it the same day. We got it the same day.
Oh, shit.
We got it the same day, man.
All right, all right.
Since you just tried to stitch me up with a girl. You tried to stitch me up.
Man.
Have you got a girl?
Nah.
Do you know, I always get that question, you know? Anytime have you got a girl? Like, they put me, like...
But you see, sometimes, you're seeing someone, you don't really know...
Where it's going.
So you just...
Bro, do you know what? Before, I used to say yes. So I didn't piss anyone off. Like, have you got a girl? I got a girl, so just so I didn't piss anyone off.
It's true.
Do you get me?
Before you start getting the message. What's up?
So what is it then? Like, I'm not on it.
You see that situation, awkward. Awkward question. I hate the whole... so what's going on with us?
Come on, man. I see you every night. Like, come on, babe. We don't have to give it no time, man. Come on, man.
The worst thing you could ever get from a girl, is a text message saying we need to talk. You just know. Bro.
It's long, man. It's long.
So we don't need... What do we need to talk about?
It's long,
Trust
man.
Me, man.
Do you know what's mad? I was in a relationship for a long time. Doing the music as well. And it's just like, it's so hard to balance. Because you don't want to disrespect the and come out and say, no, I ain't got a girl. But you don't want to scare away the girls. Do you know what I mean? So it's like, yo, do you got a girl? Like, and I'm like, yeah. But obviously, like, and the girls are asking you, like, oh, so do you have a girl? But you don't even know if it's your girl's friends or not. Do you know what I mean? So do you have a girl? And you're like, like, you don't know if they know, do you get what I mean?
Trust, it's so true.
It's hard, man.
It's so true. Thinking about all that, it's just like, I don't know if it's me or the girls, but my relationships have been like, probably the longest one's like 2 months. Big man thing.
I think it's you, man.
It could be the girls. Do you know what? I think I'm unlucky, It's always the wrong girls. No joke, the second I get in a relationship, all the girls that I've ever wanted, they want to talk to me. They want to meet up. Always happens.
Bro.
Always happens. And you see, even if you're not planning to do anything, the second you go meet them and that, it's like,
it's finished.
It's just the energy changes.
Yeah.
Like, your energy changes towards the girl that you're seeing.
Yeah. Do you know what's weird? It's weird. My relationship's always been quite long.
Mm.
I don't know.
Flipping now, man. Teach me, man. How do you do it?
I don't know, but I don't know if that's a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, though, because I'm single now.
Of course it is.
It doesn't work out.
Yeah, that means the next one you get with, that's going to be for life.
Oh, I hope so, man.
You're going to be locked up.
I hope so. I'm ready for some kids, man.
I don't know if I'm ready for that yet.
You're not ready?
No.
I think I'm ready.
That is long, fam.
You know why? I want to still be the cool dad. That I want to be like that picking up my kid from school.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
And I'm still
young,
cool.
Right?
Yeah, I'm still. Your dad's cool, man. I don't want to be the old guy like waiting outside the gate. Like,
true.
Dad's there. Like, you know what I mean? I don't want to be that guy, but.
Nah, I know what you mean.
I still want to live my life, though. So it's like.
That's the problem. That's the problem. It's like finding the right balance, especially like my nightmare is like having a kid with like a chick that I like and then. It just turns mad, and then you're in a situation where it's just not healthy for anyone. But obviously, don't always happen like that.
Of course.
You just gotta pick them right. That is it, man.
But how do we pick them? That's the question. We gotta ask Link Up. You get me?
Link Up. How do we pick these girls?
How do we pick these girls, man?
Rashida.
Yo, we start like doing CVs, man.
No, I was gonna say, like, what's next for you? What's the next move?
Do you know what the last few months I've like been recording a lot.
Yeah.
Like doing a lot of recording, man, and just working on like the album.
Yeah, that's gonna be sick.
Yeah, and then a lot of like, I'm ready to drop some underground stuff as well. Like, I just kind of been doing both, man, just enjoying it, bro. Like,
yeah, yeah.
This year I've had a lot of fun, man. Like,
yeah.
Like, I've been doing that, like, I've done like loads of festivals and all of that. So, just been enjoying and learning as well, man. Because in this thing, I feel like we're always learning.
Yeah.
Like, we're always learning, man. Things are always changing in the industry and stuff, like.
Always.
So, like, I've been learning a lot, man. So, but I'm ready, man. I've got so much tunes that I just want to put out.
Yeah, I saw a clip of, the new one that you got, yeah, that one looks mad.
Yeah, it's crazy.
That one looks mad.
Do you know what's mad? Like, for so long after 8 or 9, I was trying to make another club one.
Yeah.
But I realised when you try to make a club tune, it doesn't work.
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't, like, it's just a natural. Like, even when I done 8 or 9 with Sneakball, it was like, it was just a natural one.
Yeah.
Do you get what I mean? But this one to come along again, it was just a natural one. And, everyone's loving it, man. So, like, I've been previewing it at shows.
Yeah.
Like, just playing the hook and it's just going down. So,
that is sick, that one scene.
What's next for yourself?
For me, I'm working on a couple projects myself. I don't want to put too much out there. But I'm going to put out a lot more music, you know what I mean? And just some sick collabs and whatnot.
Sick, man.
And finishing the album as well.
I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah, definitely, man. So, yeah, man, let's catch up another time.
100%.
When you got the bangers out.
When you got the bangers out, fam. You're the man.
And then I'll update you on the girl thing. I'll let you know how it's going.
Make sure.
All right, bro.
Done, family.
Cool, yeah.
Cool.